So I bought my first Nvidia Quadro graphics card recently. Not a fancy Tesla model or anything like that, a pretty low-key one. But it's not really for any of the intended uses that might come to mind when you think of what Quadro cards are typically used for. I'm not doing any sort of complex computing and I have yet to get into 3D work, although that has always been on the list. I purchased a Quadro card to try and solve some of my Nvenc video encoding issues by having it as a dedicated encoding card. Did my strange use case work out, or did I waste my money?
They're behind us.
Who?
They have an Orisa.
Orisa? Where?
Don't go around the corner.
Huh?
You better, don't.
I just see a rock. Oh. Cool. Dude, will you just get a mod mic already? It attaches to any headphone so you can use that good pair that you like, but I'll actually be able to understand your callouts. It also has a mute switch so that I don't hear all those darn conversations with your grandma. We gotta get serious if we're gonna get out of plaid. Yeah, just order one tonight. Head on over to antlionaudio.com to learn more and check it out. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun. Today, talking about my journey setting up my Nvidia Quadro as a secondary graphics card. The journey isn't completely over, but I've made most of the progress I can make for some time. I had a few problems I wanted to solve. Performance issues using the Nvidia hardware encoder, or Nvenc, in OBS Studio with certain games that cause 100% GPU load on my GTX 1080. Issues using OBS to record itself with Nvenc, for obvious reasons, and OBS Studio not letting me record at all with Nvenc when Adobe Premiere is open. While some people like to act like expansion or accelerated cards are dead, I frequently imagine situations in which they would be extremely helpful. This is one such situation. I thought about it and realized that a dedicated Nvidia graphics card to run the Nvenc encoder would probably be the perfect solution for all of my problems. The cheapest solution would have been the GTX 1050 or a 1050 Ti, a lower end gaming card, but has the same encoding power as my GTX 1080. But I only have one slot of space free for either X16 sized PCIe slot in my machine, and the only single slot 1050 or Ti card that I found from NO3D is seemingly only available overseas and was for twice the price that I was hoping to pay. I started looking at Quadro cards, finding lots of cheap used ones on eBay. But taking a look at Nvidia's spec page for Nvenc, I'd need a Pascal series Quadro to do the level of encoding that I want. But that left a very cheap option for a new one, an Nvidia Quadro P400, a $125 graphics card resembling of budget GPUs from the early 2000s, but with three mini DisplayPort outputs. It was single slot, and according to the spec page, would support Nvenc encoding at 4K and up to 8K in HEVC H.265 mode. Perfect. Ordered from Newegg and it arrived literally the next day. I installed it in what I thought was the only available slot, booted up my PC, and the Nvidia control panel recognized it right away. Here's where I made my first potentially fatal mistake. I thought it would be smart to download the Quadro-specific drivers from Nvidia's website and install them. The installer ran like normal, but by the time it was done, I was left with a black screen across all monitors and a cursor. I could move the cursor around, it would change, presumably based on what was underneath of it, but the overall Windows GUI just would not render. I rebooted a few times, tried monitors on both the Quadro and the GTX 1080, logged into Windows via Windows Hello with my Brio webcam, and even removed the Quadro from the machine altogether, nothing would work. Let's just say Nvidia Quadro and GeForce drivers do not get along together. I actually had a friend go through a similar issue when setting up an eGPU on his laptop recently, but clearly I did not learn from his mistakes. Thankfully, I was able to just power cycle it during boot enough times to trigger Windows recovery mode, and then boot into safe mode. From there, I downloaded and ran DDU, Display Driver Uninstaller. I have a tutorial for it up on the channel, by the way, and I wiped all graphics drivers and rebooted. Back into Windows. This time, I just installed the GeForce drivers for my 1080 and left it as is. An hour and a half later, and I was back where I started. But the Nvidia control panel did recognize it, so I decided to proceed. But then, there was more panic. This whole decision was all reliant on my memory that OBS Studio would allow me to select which graphics card it ran on. The option was there. I remember it being there. What happened to it? It turns out that OBS Studio never implemented that feature to begin with, so eventually they just removed the empty menu. But that's not even what I needed in the first place. That selection controls which GPU the monitors and game renders are pulled from and where the canvas compositing happens, not where Nvenc encoding happens. After chatting with someone on Twitter, I saw my stupidity. Despite regularly making OBS tutorials and looking at the software and its menus on a daily basis, I had forgotten about the obvious setting sitting right in front of me. Not hidden in advanced settings or anything like that, but right in the encoding settings when Nvenc is selected. You can input a GPU number. By default, it's set to GPU 0, and since I've run single cards since I ditched my 660 and 9800 GT combo, I've always ignored it. By setting it to GPU 1, I was able to utilize just the Quadro for Nvenc. All sunshine and rainbows now, right? I hit recording. Encoding overloaded. The files were choppy and glitched. Even at lower recording settings, the card just could not handle 4K at all, or anything, really. Well, that's odd. Why would Nvidia officially list it as up to spec for even 8K encoding if it can't seem to record much at all? Checking in GPU-Z, the card's video engine was only hitting like 20% at max, but the GPU load was pegged at 100% while it was recording, and I confirmed in the logs that OBS was still using my main 1080 for the actual rendering and compositing. So, what gives? And this is where actually reading the manual for your computer hardware and developing an intimate knowledge of the platform you're working on comes in handy. This is something I did with my old FX build, Zarya, but hadn't taken the time to do with my new X99 build, Zazima. My X99A2 motherboard has the X16 slots laid out in a specific way, and the one I was trying to use was limited to PCIe 2.0, and I was getting like X1 speeds, which was nowhere near enough bandwidth for 4K recording at all. My motherboard had four X16 slots, three of which ran at Gen 3 speeds. One was taken up by my GTX 1080, one by my Intel 750 series NVMe boot SSD, and the last one never seemed to work when I plugged in normal capture cards and such into it. But by digging into my BIOS and manually setting the speed, I was able to make it work and move over my Quadro P400 to that slot. I had to limit my GTX 1080 to X8 speed so the Quadro could run at X8 as well, but not something I should notice as an issue anytime soon. Boot back up, let the system catch back up on the change, and whammo! The Quadro was handling lossless 444 4K60 recording with no problem whatsoever. GPU load was much, much lower, and the video engine load still stayed fairly low. So that knocks out the big hurdle of my problem. My OBS course can proceed with high quality recordings. But what about Premiere? After the emotional roller coaster of this experience, all I honestly wanted was to open up Premiere Pro, open OBS Studio, hit start recording, and things just be okay. But nope! Still the same cannot initialize recording error that I had gotten before. This was incredibly frustrating, especially considering that I've been recording Premiere with Nvenc in OBS since like 2014 or 2015 without a hitch until earlier this year. Upon doing a little research related to an Nvenc-based plugin for Premiere, it looks like one of the earlier CC 2017 updates in March or April or so to Premiere Pro is what caused this problem. Suddenly, CUDA and Nvenc can't work at the same time, even though it could have before. The plugin had been broken since, and no word from Adobe on this. That's also about when I stopped being able to record it properly. An X264 just isn't fast enough, even on my i7-6900K, to really guarantee a smooth 4K60 recording while doing heavy editing in Premiere. I even tried going back to 17.0.2 via Creative Cloud, and that didn't fix the issue, just cleared out my effects presets. In theory, if it was a CUDA plus Nvenc issue, setting Premiere to only use my GTX 1080 for CUDA should fix it, right? Premiere doesn't use multiple GPUs for playback, but it can utilize them for rendering and still hooks into them. Annoyingly, Adobe doesn't give you any sort of control or options for this kind of setting. I did go into the Nvidia control panel and set both a global rule and a per program rule for all Adobe apps to only run CUDA on the GTX 1080. Rebooted, relaunched, didn't make a lick of a difference. Whatever happened in this update to break this kind of compatibility really messed it up. Now, roughly 24 hours since I started the project, at the time of scripting this video at least, I am still happy with my purchase. It's my first Quadro, and I genuinely wanted to know if it would handle Nvenc as a dedicated card and solve my problems. Having the card will help a lot with capturing the footage necessary for my 2017 OBS Studio course that I'm shooting this month, and it may make my renders faster. Or slower. I'm not really sure yet, and since Adobe doesn't let me control which GPU it uses, I'd have to manually remove the Quadro each time I wanted to test renders without it, so I don't really have the time for that right now. But if you'd like a follow-up video, I can circle back to this and provide some testing results later. It might seem like a lot to some, but a mere $125 to be able to do my work more efficiently and in a higher quality is absolutely worth it. Quadros are actually pretty neat little cards, and I'm glad I got to experience one. Plus, now I have three more video outputs that I can use for even more monitors. And if I ever do get into Blender or 3D work, I have more CUDA power to render with. I hope you enjoyed this different kind of video. I just wanted to document my progress without as much rage-filled initial response clips like I would have had if I were just vlogging the process. Like the video if you liked it. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome tech videos. If you want to buy a Quadro P400 for yourself, I have an affiliate link for you to do so with in the description down below. I'm EposVox, and I'll see you next time.
EposVox is a Patreon-supported production. Our videos would simply not be possible without the support and generosity of our patrons, whom you can see on screen right now. If you'd like to join the inner circle and get early access to videos, among other things, go to patreon.com/EposVox to learn more.